हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम प्रोफेसर वैभव डेरले फ्रॉम द केकेवा कॉलेज ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर बिजनेस मैनेजमेंट। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ ऑयल सीड प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, इन जनरली वी डिस्कस द ऑयल प्रोसेसिंग इंडस्ट्री इन इंडिया। इंडिया इज द फोर्थ ऑयल सीड प्रोड्यूसिंग इंडस्ट्री इन द नेक्स्ट ओनली टू USA, चाइना एंड ब्राजील। मेनी वराइटीज ऑफ ऑयल सीड्स, द मेजर ऑयल सीड्स are soybean, cotton seed, groundnut, sunflower, rape seed, sesame seed, copra, castor seed, palm kernels. The oils and fats are composed of mixture of glycerides of various fatty acids. The fats and oils are broadly classified into edible and non-edible. The groundnut, soybean, mustard are some of the sources of edible oil. The edible oil is a main source of fat taken in daily meals and is used for cooking purpose and salad dressing. The soap industry paint, varnishes and plasticizers industries. Oils are also used. This slide shows that the different oil seeds. The current scenario. The total oil seed production in the country during 2019-20 is estimated at 34.19 million tons, which is higher by 2.67 million tons than the production of 31.52 million tons during 2018-19. Further, the production of oilseed during 2019-20 is higher by 4.54 million tons than the average of oilseed production. This link shows that the current scenario of the oilseed producing industry. Then, process of edible oil. In this flowchart shows that the process of oilseed processing industry. First step, seed cleaning, then decorting or dehulling, size reduction, conditioning or cooling, expeller, oil filtration, packing and marketing of oil. Now, raw material preparation. Oil seeds and nuts should be properly dried before storage and cleaned to remove sand, dust, leaves and other contaminants. All the raw materials should be stored to remove stones and moldy nuts. When storage is necessary, this should be the weatherproof ventilated rooms, which are protected against the birds, insects and rodents. Some raw materials, for example groundnuts or sunflower oil seeds, needs the dehusking. The dehusking is important to give high yield of oil to reduce the bulk of material to process. Oilseed extraction methods. First one, mechanical expression. The oil seeds are compressed in various types of compression device and equipment. In this link show that the oilseed extraction. Second one, oilseed oil extraction. Extraction is a process separating a liquid from a solid system with the use of solvent. The extraction is also a process of diffusion with the help of low boiling point solvent. This process gives the higher recovery of oil and drier cake than expression. Solvent extraction is capable of removing nearly all of the available oil from oilseed meal. These extraction process provide meal of better preservation qualities and with higher protein. Third one, process of oil refining. There are serious refining processes that can be carried out after the oil has been filtered. First one, deodorizing. The volatile compound that produce bad odors can be eliminated through the process of sparging, that is, bubbling steam through the oil under a vacuum. Second one, wintering, allowing the oil to stand for a time at a low temperature so that glycerides, which naturally occur in the oil with the higher melting point, solidify and can then be removed from the oil by filtering. Third one, neutralization. The fatty acid can be neutralized by adding sodium hydroxide solution, also known caustic soda, or by stripping, which is similar process to be deodorizing. Fourth one, bleaching. The appearance of the oil can be lightened by bleaching. Oilseed cakes and meals are the residues remaining after removal of greater part of the oil from oilseed. The residues are rich in a protein and most of valuable feed for livestock. According to the method of processing, the cakes are classified into ghani press, expeller press, and solvent extracted. The oilseed cakes are in general very good source of protein, and about 95% of the nitrogen is present as true protein. The proteins of oil cakes have a low glutamic acid, cysteine, methionine, and variable but low lysine content. They may be provide good amount of B vitamin and poor sources of carotene and vitamin E. Thank you, friends, for watching my video.